Hi everyone! New tutorial to create a t-shirt visual with a Xerox effect in Photoshop. Here we go! We will import our main subject, this head, in 3D. Then we will add a layer of effect threshold, which will allow us to reduce the color field to only 2. Then on top of this layer we will add a layer of effect gradient map, which will allow us to choose the 2 main colors of our visual. I chose here to start with a flashy red and a light gray. To make our image appear more or less detailed, we will have to play with the parameters of our threshold layer. Once I have set up these layers, we will focus more on the composition of our image. I'm going to add a round shape that I'll distort to hide the top of our face. This is where we're going to inlay future elements. Before that, I'll add a brightness and contrast effect layer on top of our face so that I can directly vary the shapes of our face in a second step. With a clipping mask, I will add an invert layer that will invert the colors of my face. From here, we are going to inlay the image on our face. To add a texture and a grainy aspect, I will use the Vivid Light Fusion mode with a Dune image. I will overlay a second image of sand, this time with a lighter color Blend mode, and reduce its opacity. To play with different levels of detail in my face, I will group its layers into a group and duplicate it. I will hide the texture layers and modify the values of my brightness and contrast slider to make more detail appear on my face. Then on this last group, I will add a mask, and with a brush I will erase zones of my group to make appear the most details of the group below. Once I am satisfied, I will organize my layers and name them. In the area provided to insert more image, I will import my first photo and apply a clipping mask in my shape. I will add a layer of effect, luminosity and contrast, to be able to make appear the details of my image. I found that this area did not stand out enough, so I simply duplicated my shape and changed its color while reducing the first one. I'm going to add a second image with a silhouette, this time with a subject in my composition. To easily detour this image, I will go to the Select and Sky tabs, and then with a right click I will do a Select Inverse and hide my clack. Thanks to this, I was able to recover my silhouette and my dunes quickly. Back on our visual, I will simply copy and paste my last selection and integrate it into my composition. With the Shape tool, I will add a round line around my silhouette to make it stand out a little more in my visual. On top of this composition, I'll add a new desert image and mask out the areas I'm not interested in with a mask and brush. I'll duplicate the same image and reposition it with a clipping mask in the previous one to add more textures. The same with a brush and a mask, I will mask some areas. Then I will add a mask to my group, and one with special brush in the shape of multiple spots, I will add and remove areas so that it creates an effect of sands that evaporate. Once satisfied, I will add small details to my composition. I will import a cactus image, and like earlier in the Select and Sky tabs, then with a right click I will do a Select Inverse and hide my layer. I just have to do the same thing with my second cactus and place my images where I want. With the circle tool, I will add a wireframe circle to center my general composition. From here, I will tackle the sky of the previous composition. In a new layer group name, Sky, by selecting the shape I created at the beginning, I will use its selection to create a mask on my Sky group. Then I will import some cloud images inside. The first image I import, I will simply reduce its opacity to make my composition appear on the back. Then I'll put a mask on it and erase the excess areas. I will add a moon on top of my composition. By importing a new image, I will use my circle selection tool and simply select the moon and mask my layer. Then convert it to a dynamic object and place it. To make it stand out better, I'll add a brightness and contrast effect layer with a clipping mask and make its texture more visible. Then I'll double-click on it and in the Layer Style panel, I'll add a light outline. Once I have placed my moon where I want it, I will go back to adding clouds. Once my image is imported, I will go to the Select tab and this time, Color Range. This will allow me to choose only the white of my image and to quickly trim my cloud. I will be able to repeat the operation with other clouds. Once finished, I decided to go back to my previous composition and add a little more sandy texture. So I duplicated my image and repositioned it in a way that suited me better. I'm going to add a little detail in the background. For this, I will import another sand texture. I will add a brightness and contrast effect layer to it to remove some texture and the same with a levels layer. I will add these layers in a group to deform it and replace it. Then in the Select tab and Color Range, I will recover by masking my image with my selection, only the color of the image. Then I will create a mask over this group and by selecting my circle and instantly my selection, I will be able to erase what is outside my circle. Then with a brush, I will be able to erase the details that bother me. With the circle tool, I will add circles as a reminder in my composition. Once I like it, I will create a group of claps called text, and we will move on to the composition part of our overall visual. In Illustrator, I will create a circle, and by selecting Curvilinear Text tool, I will be able to write text around a circle shape. I'll place my text box correctly. And import the text and typography that I want to use for my visual. I will duplicate this element and change the typography of my text. Here I'll take a more calligraphic typography. With a right click and vectorize, I will vectorize my text and so I will be able to recover only the letters which interest me. Then I will come to place so as to replace the one that are in my first circle. Once it's okay, I'll simply copy and paste it into Photoshop as a smart object and place it correctly. By double-clicking on my layer, I will add an outline to it in Layer Style. We will add a title to our visual. I'm going to use a funky typography here and distort it. To do this, I'm going to go to the Distort tab and then Arc. I'm going to open the Appearance tab from here, I'll be able to modify and add effects to distort the topography. I'm going to change my Arc effect to Shell Up. With the little plus in my Aspect tab, I will add a second effect. This will be the Shell Down effect. Then a third effect, Arch. I will play with the settings of my 3D formations to get what I want. Then I'll add a wave effect that will only allow me to distort my topography. Once I am satisfied with my typography, I will copy and paste it into my composition. I will place my text and duplicate the same effect that I added the previous typography. I will add linear shapes over my typography by copying and pasting my shape over it. Then by selecting my typography, I will hide the linear shape, and in the Layer Style tab I will add an internal outline so that it reduces the thickness of my shape. Back in Illustrator, we will create a subtitle that we will distort with an arc distortion and copy and paste into our visual. If this doesn't work, simply double-click on our dynamic object. Change the deformation settings in Illustrator and save. This will automatically update our modification in Photoshop. After that, I'll add some graphic details, and once I decide I'm done with my vision, I'll group all my layers into one group. Then in the Select tab and Color Range, I'm going to grab only the red color from my image and create a mask with that selection directly on my group. Then in Layer Style, I will add the previous red color. All I have to do now is to transform my group into a dynamic object. Copy it and import it in a t-shirt mockup. And here is the result. You now know how I go about making this kind of visual. If you like the visual, it is available on my store, Redbubble, in description. Subscribe now to not miss all my next creations. See you next time.